Hello, and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading The War of Betony, which I found down here in the dungeons of Wayrest Castle. The War of Betony. Could there be a better proof of the natural perversity of Bretons than their conduct before, during, and after what history will remember as the War of Betony? By the most depraved of motivations, the most despicable of tactics, and the most ungentlemanly of triumphs, the Kingdom of Daggerfall changed the nature of warfare in the Iliac Bay, and perhaps over all, of Tamriel. In Sentinel, we call the recent carnage the Siege of Betony, but as the Book of History is writ by the victors, let us speak instead of the War of Betony. Red Guards by their nature are a modest and practical people. We are not phlegmatic like the High Elves, nor cowardly like the Wood Elves and Khajiiti. But what would infuriate and enrage the swaggering, vainglorious Nords and Bretons would not merit a shrug from a Red Guard. Had any Breton kingdom possessed the little island of Betony, it would have been covetously guarded. Betony's trade would have been so seriously restricted, its religion subjugated, its people bound by active and constant pledges and duties of vassalage. But Betony was not a Breton dominion. Betony was part of the Kingdom of Sentinel. King Lysandus, may the Old Ones continue to torment his soul for his wickedness, saw the prosperous island, which is closer to his land than to Sentinel, and his black heart turned to avarice. Through threats, lies, acts of piracy, and, finally, invasion, Daggerfall illegally took possession of the island of Betony. His court sorceress, the Lady Medora, his enchantress mother, and other experienced counselors were horrified by the brutality of his campaign and begged him to abandon his tyrannical act of war. Gradually, all dissenters were removed from court. None but the ignorant and the warmongers remained. Our late King Cameron tried to employ civil diplomacy with Daggerfall, but in the end, he made the former declaration of war. Daggerfall and Sentinel have fought many times in their 2,000 years of coexistence, and Cameron knew the black magic and espionage the Bretons considered honest warfare. Never debasing the Sentinel character by duplicating the Breton villainy, Cameron knew best how to combat Lysandus. King Lysandus's knavish battle tactics were even more perfidious than his ancestors, and the war continued to rage until it began to involve more than Sentinel and Daggerfall. Lord Gradock, ruler of Reich Gradkeep, acted as conciliator between Sentinel and Daggerfall, and eventually convinced both monarchs to meet and make peace. The ill-fated Treaty of Gradkeep began civilly. The terms of peace were discussed, agreed on, and set to paper. The terms were excessively generous. Cameron had agreed to give up some of his rights to Betony in order to placate the madness of Lysandus and bring peace back to the Iliac Bay. It was not until King Cameron read the treaty he was about to sign that he realized the outrageous perfidy of the Bretons. The treaty had actually been purposefully miswritten by the Daggerfall scribe in a desperate and ignominious attempt to trick Cameron into signing a contract different from the one to which he had agreed. The castle of Reich Gradkeep erupted into bloodbath, and the war continued. The Battle of Cringane Field was the tragic ending of the senseless war of attrition. The Cringane Field is located in between the Yarth Borrowland and the Ravenian Forest, where the armies of Sentinel and Daggerfall respectively made camp after the massacre at Reich Gradkeep. As the battle began, Daggerfall proved that she had some foul Daedric magical tricks left by blinding the Red Guard army with a wall of mist. Lysandus did not have the opportunity to gloat over his cozenage for long, for the sure arm of a Sentinel archer struck him in the throat, even through the thick swirling fog. Lysandus's son, Gothrid, who had spent the battle in lugubrious relaxation, was crowned without ceremony, and thereupon demanded a duel with King Cameron. Cameron was many years Gothrid's senior, and though a superior warrior, was exhausted from the endless warfare the boy king had been spared. Nevertheless, as a point of honor, our king agreed to the duel. The new king of Daggerfall, by dirty trick and black magic, managed to backstab our king before the duel ever began. Thus, the victor of Cringane Field and the War of Betony was Daggerfall. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Daggerfall, The War of Betony.